Hey there, Matt again with the Maya Learning Channel, and today I've got another video for you shot-based artists out there. So often when working on a production, you'll find yourself as part of a team of artists, all contributing to the same cut. In settings like that, it's super important that the shots you're working on fit seamlessly in the context of all the other shots surrounding it. After all, the audience shouldn't be able to tell where another artist's work ends and yours begins, otherwise that could end up being really distracting. But as an artist focused on your shot, your job can be hard enough without having to worry about matching things like poses, facial expressions, sight lines, speed, and tempo to shots made by other artists. Well, worry no more, because Maya 2026 actually has the ability to show your shot in the context of the entire cut right in the viewport. That means that rather than having to flip back and forth between reference images or videos and other players, you can just scrub between your work and the work of others in real time, just like how they'd be presented in the finished show itself. And as the cut gets updated by editorial or other artists doing their work, you too will get access to those updates directly in Maya, so you're always looking at the most up-to-date source of truth. This is all made possible by the power of Flow, connecting your instance of Maya with the production backend managing all these cuts. So without further ado, let's jump in and see how it works. So as I stated before, the ability to animate in context is a Flow-enabled feature, since it requires a Flow-managed backend to serve the cut data up to Maya. If your production isn't already using Flow, then this will require a bit of administrator setup before using the feature, which is detailed in a video linked in the description below. Once that's done though, all you need to do is make sure the Flow desktop service is running, and then load up Maya. Make sure you're logged in using your Autodesk identity. So as you can see here, I've got the shot I've been working on for this production of Winter Joyride loaded into my current session. This is totally optional, by the way. I could have started from an empty scene if I wanted to. To get started, I'll just go down here to the Cut Slider button. Then I'll click to load media into the Cut Slider to bring up the Flow Media Browser. Now, if you're part of only a single Flow collection that's sharing cuts with Maya, it'll automatically show up here. If you happen to be part of multiple collections, say you're a contractor working on simultaneous productions at different companies, there's a way to target the specific collection you want for a particular Maya session. Check out the article for that, linked in the description below. Now I'll just select the shot I've been assigned, and the version. And finally, I need to associate the context view with a specific camera in my scene. Then I'll click Open. And after a few seconds, the entire cut loads into my viewport, just like that. As you can see, I can now scrub the entire length of the cut, allowing me to see the shots before and after the one I'm currently working on. This works by importing the latest media of each shot directly from Flow, providing invaluable context to help me match facial expressions, motion, and tempo to the shots around mine. I can even choose the exact pipeline step to display at either the shot or entire cut level. So whether I'm a layout artist, animator, effects, or lighting artist, I can both focus on the specific context needed for my work, but also check out other contexts to gain a broader understanding of the cut as a whole. To access pre- and post-roll frames in the cut slider, aka head and tail handles, I can right-click my shot and choose to view them. The availability and amount of these frames are determined by the editorial information in the Flow production, where the director and editorial department drive the cut. And for times when I want to focus specifically on my shot, I can either use focus mode to temporarily remove the in-context shots from my view, or simply mute them out if I want to keep the entire cut timeline in view. So now that my animation is in a more polished state, I can use the Playblast shot button to generate a playblast of it. This puts the viewport into preview mode, which replaces my interactive viewport with a full-speed playblast, just like the surrounding contextual shots. I can even right-click here to load specific playblasts I might have on disk, or load other versions from the Flow server for comparison if they exist. And once I'm done reviewing, I can just as easily go back to edit mode to continue making tweaks to be replay-blasted later. And that's about everything you need to know about Flow's new Animate in Context feature. If you're interested in trying this out in your next production, I recommend checking out the Cut Slider's Explore Cut Slider button, where you can view the list of formal requirements to get set up. And if you're already using the feature in your current workflows, I'd love to hear about how it's going in the comments below. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.